All right, so this is the 2-1-2 in a nutshell. The center is going to pass the ball to the point guard. From there, we're going to immediately trap the point guard, taking away his vision. Keep in mind that while this is happening, the center is naturally going to try to cut right down the middle. It's up to you three guys to take away the passing lanes. In this defense, you have to gamble. It's not optional. It won't work unless you do. The person that has two people on the same side, get used to guarding two people at once. Sitting in the middle between them, you have to do this because as you're doing that, you're giving time for me and the other person who was trapping time to recover back into the play. All right? Once we are back in the play, we are in man-to-man defense if we ain't already forced a turnover. Cool. So the reason why we use the 2-1-2 press is if we're up a bunch of points and we want to speed the game along, possibly, you know, make everybody quit. Or if we're down a lot of points, then this is a good defense to try to speed up the game to get more possessions. All right. I'm going to break it down in film. But this was just to give y'all a chance to get the gist of it. Now let's go into actual gameplay so y'all can see the way it's performed. Alright, so here we go. Let's go ahead and jump into it. The first thing you're going to do is trap the point guard. You know, we're going to try to trap him. You know, as we trap him, number one is going to try to run down the middle. All the good stuff that I explained in the beginning. But before we jump into seeing how effective it can be, let's show you what beats it. Now, this is something I need the team to really learn. Number two right now is helping them beat the press. This guy right here sitting in the middle, he's helping them beat the press. Number eight is not helping them beat the press at all. What are they doing? They're showing themselves to the guard. So if you see the ball come into play, bam, he catches it. He's there to make a pass. He catches it. Why does this beat the press? Because it doesn't allow you to jump the passing lanes. That's why it's so important that, like, when the team is pressing, you have to put yourself in the correct spots to show yourself to the point guard so he can pass it to you and then come back and get the ball from you. Fast the play, go ahead and continue. You're going to see, because they beat the press, they end up with a wide open shot. All right, so go ahead and freeze it right here. As you can see, at this point, we finally got the press set up. Now, even though number one is wide open, the one thing we're doing with this press is we're taking the vision away from the point guard. Like, I know a lot of you guys haven't played point before, and it's easy right now to look at number one and say he's wide open. But when you've got pressure in your face, whether in real life or on a video game, it's very difficult to really see what's going on, especially if you're not used to receiving this type of pressure. Alright? Right now, Blaze is right here in the middle. I guess he's playing the middle zone. What he's supposed to do right here is kind of be in the way of a point guard, but ready to take on the middle. RDHL should be playing in between number one and the corner. That way he can show at either one given time for us to recover, which I will show y'all why that's important later in the video. But you see right here, he's gonna pass down the middle. At this point, we're gambling. Pick up 3 seconds. That's beautiful. So now they get the pass in. Cool. Now we got the trap. Now y'all can really see how this is set up. Like I say, team is set up the same way all the time. You got the guy right here, number eight, who stops right here. You got a guy in the corner, which, like I said, Reggie should be playing in the middle of both of them. Hard guard is picking up anything on the left side, ready to jump the passing lanes. And the thing I keep telling y'all, y'all don't have to worry about the center because, you know, nobody wants the center bringing the ball up the court. I mean, we have that luxury if we wanted to, but they're going to get bump steals, and they're not used to being the ones handling the ball most of the time. So you don't have to worry about the pass going there too much. As the play continues, you're going to see them come over here. Let me rewind it back so I can show you what I'm seeing. So when the ball actually does come back to this guy, he's not going to shoot the ball from half court with 20 seconds left. So, hard to guard, you're free to continue on your path. By the time he does get to the rim, RDA Chalk would have had a chance to rotate. Blaze could have rotated down to the corner. Like I said, me and Cat would have been back in the play. back in the play. So as the ball comes, as you see Cap is already back in the play, right here, this is a good chance to gamble. All right? By not gambling, you do give us time to recover, but that's a safe gamble. That's a reach you can take, and you're still going to be in front of this person to play some solid defense. That's knowing the different animations of the game. So right there, he gets a pump fake. Right there, got our hands on everything. That's a beautiful way to do it. Again, we come down, boom, the trap is there. Now, like I said, at this point, hard to guard, you should be comfortable playing against two people. So who's ever on this right side in this particular play, it could be the right or the left, you should be playing closer to the elbow of the three-point line, right? And the only reason why I'm saying that is because I don't have anybody in the middle of the floor who's really taking away number one at this point in time. Which means Artie H. Hawk has no choice but to go all the way to the corner. What's supposed to happen is Artie H. Hawk is supposed to be by the C, and then you'll be able to play by this back elbow by the three-point line. You'll be able to come up and we'll be able to rotate just as well. Now, the thing about this, watch as the play continues, that was supposed to be a steal. Blade clearly would have had the steal, but it pops up and they get the ball back. Cool. He still has to force a pass. That's a hell of a gamble by Reggie. That's what you have to live with in this situation. They are going to score some points in this defense. It's just by the time they score 2 points, we should have scored 8. And you play like that the entire quarter. So right there, they get a wide open 3. You live with that. Right here, beautiful. We got the bump by Cap. And again, me and Cap, we're not reaching in this situation. We're just trying to force him to pick the ball up, double team, take away his vision. At this point, you got Blaze playing in between two people perfectly, but you have to sit in the middle of both of them just in case you pass it either way. At this point, RDA Talk should be closer up by the three-point area. Again, I'm not worried about this guy in the corner cutting back door or nothing like that. Hard to guard can see it. He's going to be able to rotate and get there for you. And by the time we do all this, I'm telling you, me and Cap are going to be back in the play. If you don't believe me, watch the play. So the ball's passed. Look at where me and Cap is on the play. We are all the way behind. You know, Reggie plays in the middle, giving time for Blaze to recover. Hard to guard. What is he going to do? Rotate to number 8. I'm telling you, when you take away the vision of people, it's hard to see these passes. One, hard to guard is in the passing lane between number 1 and number 8, so you can't necessarily just throw it across court. And he's recovering so he can take away the paint. Now watch the play. By the time they make 2 passes, look where Cap is. He's already back in the play. And like I said, you have to gamble. So what does Reggie do right here on his dunk attempt? He gambles. He goes for the block. We get the rebound. By the time all that happened, look at where me and Cap are. We're back in the play. All right. So with that being said, it gives us a chance to get out on the break. So again, right here, Cap has to sprint all the way over here to pick up this trap. Blaze is doing a beautiful job right now taking away this passing lane, which is what I'm more impressed with right now. So as the play continues, we got the trap, we get the bump, get the steal, now we out to the races. So again, play comes down, trap is formed. Again, he's going to back up, number 1, pass the ball in, he's going to try to run down the middle or whatever. Right now, number 8 is doing a good job of breaking the press, and double 0 is doing a good job of breaking the press. They're making themselves target for the point guard to actually pass it to. Alright? At the same time, we're all doing a great job of trying to play the passing lanes, but it's a gambling game when you're in this press. So as the play comes down, Reggie gambles. Number 1 was doing a bad job of showing himself to the point guard. That's why when he's moving as the press is set, he puts himself in a position to get picked off. The number one problem we have when we go against the press is I get pressed, I got 2 people on me, or if it's a really good defender, he's jamming me. RDA talking to you, they already know they turn themselves to me and they sit still. Once they start moving, backing up, or doing something like that, That's when the steals occur. That's when all the turnovers happen. So you see right there, that guy's moving, gives you a chance to get the steal. We right back in the play. So right here, same thing, set it right back up. Come for the trap, cool. 99, which is Blaze, has time to recover. It's gonna be a bobble pass because we took away his passing lane. Like I say, yes, number one is recovering to try to get it to the paint. But the guard is already coming over to cut that off. And like I said, by the time one pass, two passes goes by, we're all back in the play. So as you can see right here, who's the one that took the ball? Cap. Let me rewind. Let me show you what I mean. Cap is number seven, okay? By the time the ball comes down here, we have already recovered to the point where Cap is already in the paint. That's how fast we can move defensively. That's how fast you guys have to process, you know, what the hell we're doing. It doesn't take long. Like, all right, like, we've been playing 2K for so long. Like, these things are natural habit at this point. So now that he caught the ball, bam, he's the one that tips it. And we all back in the play. Now we've been man to man. Right here, I'm not going to lie, this foul is on me. I'm going to foul, but it's a computer pass. If it was a normal person pass, I would have had a chance for this passing lane, which is what I was actually reaching for. They just happened to call foul because Cap would have recovered and contested beautifully. That is what it is. You know, that's how to play. That's how you play a 2-1-2 press. You get it down, I'm going to show you the benefit of using the 2-1-2 press. So at this point, the game is over, right? This is the thing that I want to show you. The final score of this game is 90-47, right? Here's the thing. We started the fourth quarter with 62 points. They started the fourth quarter with 28 points. So, excuse me, they started the quarter with 29 points. Excuse me. So, 47 minus 29 equals 18 points. 90 minus 62 is 28 points. We scored 28 points to the 18. Like I said, yes, they're going to score in this defense. But I want y'all to always think of basketball like this. If you beat a team by 5 points a quarter, you just beat that team by 20 points. So right here, we outscored them by 10. If you played this for four quarters, we would have scored 112 points. They would have scored 78 points. We just beat them by 40 with this 2-1-2 press. And that's how I always want you guys to look at the end of every quarter. We beat them by, if we beat them by however many points we're winning by each quarter, it just multiplies by the end of the game. But anyway, I hope y'all learned something today. That's the 2-1-2 press, lethal, team lethal style. I catch you guys in the next video. I'm out.